Now, I'm glad that we are meeting all the lawyers here working around Supreme Court, maybe around Delhi High Court and so on. Tomorrow is Ambedkar's birthday, and the whole nation is likely to celebrate in a new mode because of what happened on April 2nd, what I called the Dalit Spring, as it happened in, you know, Arab countries called Arab Spring. The protests that took place across North India. Now, as my friend said, I come from an OBC background. The Dalits, the backwards, and the OBCs in this country never knew till Ambedkar came to the scene of both legal discourse, political discourse, and social discourse, what is actually law at the higher level. We had our own family, caste level, legal jurisprudence, deciding things under the tree. And the justice there was altogether different. It was a people's oriented justice in presence of everybody there. And historically, we were not supposed to study the spiritual law that Hinduism evolved. And it was Mahatma Phule, Narayan Guru, Periyar Ramaswamy, and more particularly Ambedkar, who made a unusual study of this Hindu spiritual legal system. And quite surprisingly, he not only became an economics PhD holder, but a law graduate from London. And if only he were not to write this constitution, if he were not to evolve a legal framework of the kind that we have today, perhaps we would have been in the primitive stage. Now, he tried to reform largely Indian society and mainly Hindu society for a long time. And he spoke in terms of laws, how to reform. And he asked for reform from 1936 to 1956. He did not find reform in Hindu system. Then he converted to Buddhism. He did not see what constitutional and legal processes would impact in India after a long time, because he died in 1956. Two types of laws came into being because of the constitution, as Indraji said. Now, one type of law is the individual right. Whether arrest, whether crime is individual related. But the other type that has come into existence because of Ambedkar's major contribution is social reform law. That is, there is a caste system here, there is untouchability, and both caste and untouchability have implications to women. Therefore, a massive social reform law had to be put in place. And this social reform law should be executed perhaps at the legal level from High Court level and the Supreme Court level, because lower courts don't do that. Now, two major laws and the judicial interpretations around that came in. One is around reservation. The reservation, the Brahmanic people see as an anti-progressive, anti-merit, anti-them. But all of us, we see that the reservation laws as a law of introducing merit into non-meritorious Brahmanic structures. Where there is no productive merit, the productive forces have to enter into that and change the meritless into merit. This is where the gap between China and India is. Indian industries are not comparable to Chinese industry. Indian universities are not comparable to Chinese universities. I'm not comparing Europe, America, and Indian higher institutions are not comparable to Chinese. We were more or less equal. The second set of laws are SCST, atrocity kind of laws. Because here is it is a reform law. That this law in place being there, the untouchability will get reduced by very existence of law. And social relations begin to change. That's what Ambedkarite view is. Therefore, social equality begins to operate both as a practical dimension and also as a legal dimension. But more than that, from 1956 after Ambedkar died to 2014, there was one form of legal relationship between us and the courts. But after 2014, a different legal relationship has come in. A major reform that Ambedkar expected in Indian society is reform in Hindu society, Hindu system. Now, one of the reasons of caste existing there is all those who are being defined as Hindus today by the Hindu institutions and Hindu organizations, including RSS and political parties like BJP and so on, that we are all Hindus, therefore we should be equal. Now, one of the major reforms issues in any religion is the right to head the religious structure, center, the right to head the temple, the right to priesthood in Hinduism. Now, there was a recent judgment, Supreme Court judgment, on this issue. Now, look at the way how it went. In 2015, the Madras High Court judgment that all those who are considered to be Hindus and want to operate within the Hindu system, irrespective of caste, should have the right to priesthood in every temple. The Madras High Court judgment granted that, the right to priesthood, whether one is a Dalit, one is an OBC, one is a Shudra upper caste, or one is a Vaishya, one is a Kshatriya. Now, except the Brahmins, this right does not exist for anybody else. The Madras High Court said it should be given to all those whom you define as Hindu. It came to Supreme Court. And in 2015, a two-judge Supreme Court bench said that according to Agama Shastras, only inheritance-based priesthood will be given, and thereby only Brahmins can continue to be priests in Hindu temple. So it did not accept reform. It negated reform. In fact, any negation of reform in a religion is increasing the conflict in it. Judiciary is supposed to reduce conflict and help the reform process. You see the Supreme Court of America mostly helped the reform process. The same Supreme Court in the case of Muslims was for reform. Triple talaq, it is for reform. Okay, Muslim women asked for reform. So, now assuming that you want Hinduism to be intact, Hinduism to be what it should be, as the present government wants to, then you should be accepting reform and moving in that direction. And in this case, I don't know, Indraji, whether you looked at it, the government did not even put its intervention, the central government, as it put its intervention in triple talaq case. So they want reforms in Islam, they don't want reform in Hinduism. Now, how are you lover of Ambedkar? This is the question. Every day you are saying we are most, you know, admirers, most worthy praisers of Ambedkar, we embrace him. But you are not, even after his death, after he left Hinduism in disgust, you are not for reform. Second, this SCAT Atrocity Act, the present judgment is totally against social reform at the ground level. Now in this, there are two things that they are trying to do. One is the cases in the officialdom are between Dalits and the top upper caste. The cases in the rural areas are between Dalits and broadly OBCs. Because there are no top upper caste there to engage agricultural production, have the relationship between labor and tilling the land and so on. So now OBC has not come to High Court or Supreme Court. There are a number of cases on OBCs. But the officials from higher structures came and the Supreme Court intervened. Now they are trying to consolidate OBCs in favor of them against Dalits. So this is, now even assuming that you will win the election tomorrow with this, what is social reform going to do? What will happen to the nation? Secondly, reservation, they are saying, you know, when Arunabh Goswami was in the Times Now, they every time call me whenever there is reservation issue. Because they need somebody to argue in favor, somebody against, then we should fight, then viewers will be increasing there. So one day, Arnab called me and started, this was a day when the MP's committee said there should be private reservation in private sector. So he called me for a debate. In the opening he started, Professor Kancha Ilaiah, you have already destroyed merit in all government institutions. You. Now you are planning to destroy merit in private sector also. You know how he talks. This night. This night, the whole nation is viewing. It should be settled here. So 2 minutes, he said, Professor Kancha Ilaiah, what do you think? So I heard for 2 minutes. Then in my own typical style, very slowly I said, Arunav, can I speak now? This is your TV. Then, yes, now you have to reply me. The nation is viewing. Nation is viewing. I said, there is no merit with you at all. Then he said, what do you mean you are accusing me personally? You were doing that for 2 minutes? Then I said, if you had merit, you combine merit with nationalism. If you had merit, I know what is your caste background, you know what is my caste background. I have already added shepherd word, in not in Sanskrit but in English, because to go away from that Sanskrit, to tell my caste background. You tell me what is your caste background. You are running all the industries now. What is the competence merit of your industries? You are not there in agricultural production. You are not there in food production at all. There are no Brahmins in food production at all in this country. And food is surplus. We are producing. And you are there in all the industries, Ambani, Adani, Reliance, Kirloskar, and every sector. Your industry is totally incompetent in the world. And I said, unless we come into that industry and inject merit into that of production, this industry will not improve. You please vacate industry, we will come and save them. What are you before Chinese industry? And you say, vegetarianism is nationalism. And you say, yoga is national game. So you eat only vegetarian, dal, birakaya, bendakaya, pappu, everything, and go and stand on the Chinese border to fight the Chinese soldiers. Chinese soldiers, you know what they eat? Beef, pork, snake, frog, whatever is not poison, they eat. And you know what is their game? You go and all your TV channels go and stand there, China will come with karate. Who will win the battle? You are not there on the border. SCST OBCs are protecting the nation. Is there a Brahmin regiment to protect the nation on the borders? There was Mahar regiment, there was Ahir regiment, there was Jat regiment, there was Sikh regiment. And you say, anti-national. So, if we criticize anything, we become anti-national. I said, look, if you don't fight for repeal of cow protection laws, China will occupy India. Because our youth are not eating well. Their protein level has gone down. You can stop eating meat only after you become 60. All of us three on the dais can stop only live with vegetarian, but not all these people. Their procreation and production will become weak. So the question is, this, with this kind of brain, you cannot improve India as a nation and abolish caste and establish a society of equality to compete with a nation. Always they are trying to compete with Pakistan. I said, this is a small mind. If you have any mental ability, you should compete with China, which is equivalent in population and equal in civilizational strength and a national character. But look at China today, where they are, where you are. And not only, secondly, reservation is very bad. I said, we will fight against reservation tooth and nail. But you all should join us in abolishing private English medium schools and establishing English medium in government schools on equal basis for everybody. You give us 25 years. Let us, let Arun Jaitley's children, you know, Arun Jaitley, Arun Shauri, Advani and all their children study only in St. Stephen's, not in St. Brahma's college. And they say, Christianity is bad. We have never studied, and I have never studied in any Christian school. I have studied under the tree in Telugu medium. When I was learning English, I was not getting it. I went to my under the tree goddess Pochamma, because my goddess understands all languages. So I asked her, Pochamma goddess, please teach me English. She said, please give me some ram and some kallu and some sara, and then I will teach you English. I got this English, not from Christian school college. They go to there, and you establish all private English medium schools and establish government regional language schools for our children. And we are now classical. What is the situation today? After BJP came to power, in all central institutions, Narendra Modi ji said, I am an OBC. When he said, I am an OBC, I thought he must have been a Shudra. Some tilling land, some looking after cattle, feeding some buffalo, some cow, some... No, he is not a Shudra OBC, he is a Baniya OBC. He sold some oil, sometime, later some chai. See, selling anything is a business. It's not production. So he came, I'm an OBC, our OBCs went along with him and voted for him. But now, who are ruling the system? All the institutions are headed by Dronacharyas. And what is the Dronacharya culture? They say, you should not learn. You should take admission in universities and you should not read books at all. Reading books is not their culture. If you read book, you have to give your thumb and live. I mean, then whom are you competing with? What are you doing to nation? So the question today is, reservation laws are meant to be nullified by the Supreme Court. Now my appeal to judges is that if you don't allow reform in your own Hindu society, if you are thinking you are Hindu, the conflict is inevitable. And the conflict may either reform democracy or even destroy democracy. Ambedkar was for reform, growth and transformation. I think judges and lawyers must read Ambedkar from annihilation of caste to Karl Marx, or Karl Marx and Buddha. That was the last essay that he wrote. If lawyers don't read Ambedkar, India will not survive. Lawyers must read others. You know, lawyers definitely must read Gandhi, his book called My Experiments with Truth. Now, I have written my own autobiography with the title My Experiments with Untruth. Our life is untruth. We till the land, it is untruth. We looked after sheep, goat, buffalo, everything is, and buffalo gives 75% of our milk. But it is not a respectable animal in Supreme Court. Because why? Because it is a black animal. I asked Justice Verma when we were going to Durban, he was on the committee, Vajpayee ji appointed, whether caste should be shaken. So the committee sat, and I said, Justice Verma ji, if one fine morning a buffalo walks into your Supreme Court when you were Chief Justice and says that I should have equal right with cow, either you put me in the Constitution preamble or remove cow from Constitution, either of that, what would you have done? you would have first dismissed watch and ward staff. How did you allow this buffalo, black buffalo, into Supreme Court? And ask them to wash the whole Supreme Court with milk. But whose milk? Again the buffalo milk. Now why should it be washed? Because it is a black animal. Is black bad? Yes, black is very bad. Black is very bad on the buffalo body, but when our air becomes white, you must paint it very black. See, what is this? Law is becoming superstition. If law is become goes around superstition, Ambedkar's constitution will not survive.